say we wanted to write an expression where 2 is multiplied together 5 times. The notation we have is very cumbersome. And if we wanted to write this expression multiple times, you could imagine how much time it would consume. An alternative way we could write this expression is using this notation. This notation is called exponential notation. The larger number, called the base, tells us what number is being used as factors. The exponent is the small superscripted number to the upper right. It tells us how many times we multiply the base. If we evaluate 2 to the 5, we get 2 multiplied 5 times, which simplifies to 32. The product of an exponential function is called a power. In our example, we would call 32 a power of 2. Now, there are many ways to vocalize our exponential expression. It could be read as 2 to the power of 5, 2 to the 5th power, or 2 to the 5th. All of these mean the same thing. Now, there are some special names for certain exponents. When an exponent is 2, we call it squared because it represents the area of a square. When an exponent is 3, we call it cubed because it represents the volume of a cube. Okay, now let's do a bit of practice. What would this notation mean? The base is 4 and the exponent is 3. So we are told to multiply 4 together 3 times. 4 times 4 is 16, times 4 is 64. So 4 to the power of 3 is 64. Let's try another one. What would 2 to the power of 5 equal? See if you can do this on your own. Go ahead and pause. The base is 2 and the exponent is 5. This means we multiply 2 together 5 times. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 is 16, 16 times 2 is 32, so 2 to the power of 5 is 32. Here's another question. What is negative 7 squared? Take a moment to think about this. Now, the first question we need to ask is, what is the base here? Looking at this question, it may look like negative 7 is the base, but this is actually not the base. If negative 7 were the base, we would get negative 7 in parentheses to the power of 2. However, we don't have parentheses here. This means that this expression is the same as negative 1 times 7 squared. The negative sign is not being squared. So, let's first find 7 squared. 7 is the base and 2 is the exponent. So we multiply 7 twice, which gives us 49. Now we find negative 1 times 49, which is negative 49. Now, if we used negative 7 as the base, we would have gotten negative 7 times negative 7. The negative signs would cancel out, leaving us with positive 49, which is an incorrect answer. So it's important to keep track of your signs. Only exponentiate them if they are in the parentheses. Otherwise, leave them as they are. Okay, one more. What is negative 5 to the power of 3? Well, negative 5 times negative 5 is 25, and 25 times negative 5 is negative 125. So negative 5 to the power of 3 is negative 125. Awesome work. Now, there are some helpful properties that come with exponents. The product of powers property, the quotient of powers property, and the power of a power property. Notice that in each of these properties, the base is the same. Let's see all these at work in examples. If we multiply 2 to the power of 2 and 2 to the power of 3, because they have the same base, the product of powers property says we should get 2 to the power of 5. Let's see if this is the case. 2 squared is 4. 2 cubed is 8. 4 times 8 is 32. And is 2 to the 5th 32? Yes, it is. Now, if we divide 3 to the power of 4 by 3 to the power of 2, the quotient of powers property tells us we should end up with 3 to the power of 2. 3 to the power of 4 is 81, and 3 squared is 9. 81 divided by 9 is 9, which is 3 to the power of 2. So this worked as well. And what if we had 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 3? Well, the power of a power property tells us that this should equal 2 to the power of 6. 2 to the power of 2 is 2 times 2, which is 4. And 4 to the power of 3 is 4 times 4 times 4, which is 64. What is 2 to the power of 6? 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 is 32, and times 2 one more time is 64. So these indeed match. Awesome. Now, here's a question for you. What would something raised to the power of 0 equal? How can we multiply a number 0 times? That's not possible. Anything raised to the power of 0 is 1. To think about this, we can apply the quotient property. Anything to the power of 0 is the same as dividing that number by itself. This we know is 1. So anything to the power of 0 is 1. Now, how do we find powers with negative exponents? Here we have 3 to the power of negative 2. How can we multiply 3 negative 2 times? That doesn't quite make sense. Instead, let's approach this differently. A negative exponent doesn't mean we multiply negatively. It means we take the reciprocal of the base. This would be the same as 1 over 3 to the power of 2. 3 to the power of 2 is 9, so this would be 1 over 9. Now, why does this work? Let's consider the quotient of powers property. If we have 3 to the power of 2 divided by 3 to the power of 4, we should get 3 to the power of negative 2. 3 to the power of 2 is 3 times 3, which is 9. And 3 to the power of 4 is 3 multiplied 4 times, which evaluates to 81. 9 divided by 81 is 1 over 9. And we can also think of this as 1 over 3 to the power of 2, which is the reciprocal of 3 to the power of 2. Let's do some quick practice on negative exponents. What would this expression be? Well, since we have the negative, we could write this as 1 over 2 to the power of 3. We know that 2 to the power of 3 is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. So this would evaluate to 1 over 8. Cool. Now, what about this expression? What would this equal? The negative exponent tells us that this can also be written as 1 over 1 third to the power of 1. And what is 1 third to the power of 1? Well, when the exponent is 1, there is only one factor to multiply, so it equals the base. 1 third to the power of 1 is 1 third. So we have 1 over 1 third. We can multiply this by 3 over 3, which gives us 3 over 1, which is 3. So this exponential expression evaluates to 3. Awesome work. Now, all the exponents we looked at so far were integers. How can we raise a number to a fraction? This is called the root. Now, you may be familiar with square roots or cube roots already. This is the same concept. Roots can also be written as a fraction exponent. The denominator tells us the degree of the root. For example, if we raised something to the power of 1/2, we are finding the square root. What number, when multiplied together twice, makes 81? 9. When taking fraction exponents, we always take the principal root, meaning only the positive answer. So 9 is our answer. Now, if the denominator was a 3, now we are finding a number which, when multiplied by itself 3 times, equals the base. In this case, we know that 3 multiplied 3 times equals 27. So that's our answer. And we can keep going. What number, when multiplied by itself 4 times, equals 16? 2. So 16 to the power of 1/4 is 2. Okay, let's practice. What is 25 to the power of 1/2? Well, what number, when multiplied twice, equals the base, 25? The principal root of 25 is 5. So that's our answer. 25 to the power of 1/2 is 5. Now, what about 8 to the power of 2/3? Give this one a shot on your own. Alright, to think about this one, we can use the power of a power property to rewrite this expression as 8 to the power of 1/3 to the power of 2. All we did was factor the exponent. So now, first we need to find the cube root of 8. What number, when multiplied by itself 3 times, is 8? 2. So if we replace 8 to the power of 1/3 with that, now we have 2 to the power of 2. 2 squared is 4, so this expression, 8 to the power of 2/3, is 4. Awesome work. That was a lot. Now, let's recap. Exponential notation consists of two parts, a base and an exponent. The base tells us what factor we are using, and the exponent tells us how many times we are multiplying the base. A power is the result of raising a base to an exponent. For example, 8 is 2 to the power of 3, so 8 is a power of 2. Anything to the power of 0 is 1, and anything to the power of 1 is itself. We've also looked at a few properties of exponents in this video that make simplifying exponents easier. The product of powers property, the quotient of powers property, and the power of a power property. Negative exponents tell us to find the reciprocal, and fraction exponents tell us to find the roots. Awesome job! Pat yourself on the back, we just touched on a lot of concepts concerning exponents. If this was your first time hearing all or some of this, it may be quite overwhelming at first, but you did great. And there you go, that's an introduction to exponents. As always, if you learned something, like, subscribe, and share it with a friend. And keep working hard, and keep learning. Thank you for watching.